All right, hello everybody, this is Starman, and welcome back to Let's Play Leisure Suit Larry, Wet Dreams Dry Twice. Well, you remember last time, we took up the task of trying to get Becky to improve the Yelp rating of the hotel so that we could finish paying off our debts, which, thanks to our handy-dandy to-do app, we do have a couple of notes here. We have to get the pool clean and make the water smell good. We have to get her a selfie worthy cocktail. We have to make the hotel buffet completely vegan. Which we've taken some steps toward doing that by making the rather disgusting food the base for a rather healthy looking salad bar, but we need to get rid of that pig somehow.
The pig is bound to a spit. At any rate, it's a good thing for the pig that the barbecue is off. For now.
Yeah, I missed that
the
part in the middle.
The pig is bound to a spit. The spit isn't turning. Either the pig is too heavy, or the spit has no power. At any rate, it's a good thing for the pig that the barbecue is off. For now.
So we need to figure out some way of getting the pig barbecued or getting out of here. Unfortunately, picking it up...
If I untie that pig, it'll bite my arm off. Everybody knows pigs do that. Nasty animals, unless they're barbecued.
And yeah, you might be thinking maybe there's a way to make the pig more docile. Well...
It might calm it down, but I can't get it into its mouth.
Which is actually a hint to a puzzle later. But first thing first is we have to get the pig off the spit in the first place. But before we start tackling that problem and everything else, there is one location we have not visited yet on the ground floor. And you'll note that the gate is open over here on the pathway to the ocean. And Bobby mentioned that there was a woman named Emma who had taken charge of our raft. And Emma happens to be over this way.
Hey, that's my raft!
That's junk, and it's going to be recycled.
Okay.
My beloved raft.
Hey, hands off!
Okay, so clearly we cannot do anything with that while she is here.
It's locked up nice and tight.
She has a corncob pipe for some reason.
That's one of those modern folding computers. Better not. I might mess something up.
Since when has that stopped you before, Larry?
It's quite attractive. Can I have the magnet?
Sure. Now that I have my metal detector, I don't need it anymore.
Okay, so score. We have a magnet.
I don't need that. I know what planet I'm on.
It doesn't always seem so.
A world flag. How unpatriotic. She must have her reasons for wearing a beanie in this heat. Hi, I'm Larry. Larry Laffer.
Hi, I'm Emma.
Lovely name.
Thanks.
Are you a messy?
What?
Well, because you can't seem to throw anything away. All you have to do is throw it in the ocean and it'll float away. Practical.
Are you trying to provoke me?
What? Absolutely not.
It sure seems that way. You may be too young for it, but you seem a lot like one of those guys who's responsible for the state the world is in.
Guys who did everything right in the 80s.
Okay, boomer.
I don't have a boomerang. What did you do to my raft?
Your what?
There, in that net.
Wait, you threw that piece of junk in the water?
That's not junk. That's outstanding engineering.
I already complained to Governor Marley about that. She wanted to find the culprit and hit him with a heavy fine. So it was you.
Don't worry, she already found me. And man, did she find me. What are you doing here anyway?
I am an environmental activist. Wherever nature gets polluted, I am there to save it.
And that just coincidentally happens to be the nature on a tropical island?
You see the kind of junk people throw in the water here?
Stop calling my beautiful raft a piece of junk.
Never!
How'd you find my raft so quickly?
I've placed sensors all over Kahlua. Water temperature, wind, pH values, solar radiation. I can monitor everything here from my control center in real time. Plus, I've set up a few cameras on the island.
Sounds like you don't miss much.
I never sleep. I comb the beach with a metal detector. The things I find there, some people even just bury their old consumer electronics.
What monsters?
She searches the beach a lot, you say.
You didn't by any chance find a key somewhere near the hotel, did you?
Yes, I have.
How exactly?
On one of my patrols with the metal detector. I was going to take it back to the governor.
Oh, I can do that for you. I'm going back to the hotel anyway.
That would be great. Here.
Have you by any chance seen a pretty blonde anywhere?
I try to avoid people as much as possible.
Her name is Faith. Ring any bells?
No.
A bit of a glitch there.
Now give me back my raft.
Not a chance. I will not allow this raft to deface these beautiful waters again.
I could actually hear the quotation marks. I want to report some serious pollution.
What? Where?
Someone at the hotel has a plastic bag.
That is a structural problem in our society, and the government has to step up to the plate.
So now it's suddenly the government's responsibility.
That's what I said.
There's a guy driving around in an SUV on the other side of the island.
Well, I can't save the whole world. Right now, I'm only taking care of this part of the island.
That's a double standard.
No, it's pragmatism.
Someone's swimming naked down at the beach.
That's not pollution.
It is visually. Besides, they might be in it.
Oh, I've got bigger threats to the environment to deal with.
And yeah, a bit of a hint here, but...
Some monster poured oil on the water at the hotel.
My sensors already told me that.
And why are you still here?
The oil spill is annoying, but it isn't big enough to be dangerous to wildlife. Fortunately, birds are intelligent enough to avoid the spill on their own.
So you're not going to do anything about the oil?
As long as it doesn't endanger any animals, I'll rate it a priority level 3. First thing I have to do today is to sort this junk out for recycling.
That's still my raft.
Okay.
I made a mistake. Everything's clean. I have to be going.
So yes, clearly we will need to make some type of disaster to distract Emma to get our raft back at some point.
Oh! You want to dispose of that properly. Thanks! Just be sure to put them in a lockable container. Otherwise, some poor animal might get caught in it.
Wouldn't that be a shame? Hint, hint.
A six-pack ring without the beer. What a sad sight. The key is pretty well secured. It's strong enough to attract small metal objects.
Like, say, for instance, the coins
in
the well?
You know you're in trouble when the only big thing you have is your trombone. Hey, there's something sparkling in the water. I managed to fish out a quarter, but... then the magnet fell in.
Well, a quarter is still a quarter.
It fits. I really don't want to look too close. Okay, let's see.
Because this is a Leisure Suit Larry game, of course, you can use the bathroom.
I just went. Maybe later.
And later in this case will mean just walking off screen, thankfully. Because we do have another reason for needing to use the bathroom.
Then, I'll just go on in.
And I think we're done. No.
Oh, this is where I found that yellow liquid.
And yeah, I think that might be a mistake on the track, but...
Well, like I said, it's my... No, a pee-pee-colored liquid. I don't want to go into detail.
Okay, which I think gives us everything we need to make a drink. So...
It needs some orange flavor.
Let's see, orange flavor condom. Ice, we actually need to get the ice up from the top floor in Fate's room.
Liquid as yellow as a sunset.
Which we have now.
And it needs some green liquid in it, too. A proper cocktail has to shine on its own.
Glow stick.
Of course, it definitely has to have alcohol in it.
Vodka.
Enough.
Okay, so we gotta get the ice, but there is one more thing we need to pick up while we're here.
Somehow hot.
Because we noticed that the rooster up there was looking a wee bit excitable.
The ducky fits perfectly. Like, all it needs now is a partner in there. That rubber ducky won't be coming out of there so easy.
And I'm going to go ahead and save the game here really quick. Because I had issues with the game crashing the first time I did this.
I'll hang that up there. I can't reach the stairs because the hot spring is blocking the way.
And this can not load properly if you're standing in the wrong place.
Did you see that, Pie? That horny cock actually fell for the sexy rubber ducky. Forgot absolutely everything around him and just blindly threw himself on it. What a cock.
Indeed. Nothing like that could ever happen to you, Larry.
Of course not. He's stuck tight.
I hate when I get my cock stuck in things. Oh, what, like you weren't thinking it?
It's frozen.
All right, so now that we have some ice, we can assemble this. And curiously enough, the ice won't melt once it's in here.
It needs...
So orange flavor there, ice there, yellow liquid, green liquid, shine, and booze.
Wonderful. A textbook peaky twister.
Let's not forget what's in there, shall we? And you won't let anyone drink it.
Of course I won't let anybody drink it. But if Becky...
No.
All right, all right. A cocktail is like a good hot dog. As long as you don't know what's in it, it looks delicious. Somehow hot. Why do animals always look so unhappy when I keep them in my pants?
It's a mystery, Larry. It really is.
I have a selfie-suitable cocktail for you.
So cool! Wait just one minute, Buster. I'm not taking any more drinks from you.
The bartender mixed it.
Okay. That's all right, then.
But, you'd better not drink too much of it.
Hmm? It's just for some fresh selfies. I can even suck on a straw without swallowing.
I'm warning you.
What?
Now, I can give one more point on gulp.
I have to go influence somewhere else now.
Okay. So, we're down on one of the three things we need to do. Now, the other thing we need to do, as I said, was need to get rid of the pig. And we're going to do that by messing around with the electricity.
So let's see.
As you can see, this is a bit of a jumbled mess, and there's some broken bits here.
This is where the cable is cut. No electricity can pass the way it is now.
And one of the switches is missing a lever, and there's a bunch of little switches here, but this is not as impossible a fix as you might think. We just use some tin foil to fix the broken connection.
That bridges the gap.
And we use our fork.
That's a perfect fit. And now it's a working lever again.
Okay, so we are going to need to get all of these to work at least once. So we'll go ahead and start from top to bottom. Try and get the background here done first. So we'll make sure all the connections are going from that switch to there and that switch to there. And needs to be positive on that one and negative on that one. Yep, so hit the big red button and wait.
That didn't work.
Flip the wrong connection. Actually needs to be going there and needs to be positive, so
to admit it's a clever way to get rid of waste oil.
Out of sight, out of mind. That is your motto.
And what's odd is that when I first played through this, I opened this up before I talked to Emma, and there was a pile of oil barrels you had to push over to...
Other slicks are slicker.
...make this look disgusting. Thankfully...
Remember, Bird. This is all for a good cause.
You mean yours?
That's what I said.
Okay, so one thing down.
So let's see.
We can now use that to distract Emma. So thing number two, the air conditioner. Which we are going to crank the heat up on. And connect to the red. Actually, no, connect to the green. That has to be negative. All right, we can see that the AC is now cranked up. Nice and hot.
So let's see.
Okay, now the barbecue. That one we want that turned to positive, and the that one turned to positive. So yeah, we turned up the heat, but that pig is just too fat for the spit to turn effectively.
So let's see.
And then we have the control for the ceiling fan, which we can set to the slow, medium, and super fast.
Now that's what I call torque.
Okay, we now have the ceiling fan going full tilt, but that doesn't do us much good. But,
So let's see.
And I must confess, this one held me up for a little bit, but the trick is... you hit the reveal key, it'll show you everything you can mess with, including the plugs on the right.
I can't get that out. It's screwed in too tight.
A feeling that is not wholly unfamiliar to me. But we can actually switch out these two, because they are not plugged in all that tight. So we switch the barbecue controls into the fan switch.
Fly free, you swine!
Is that your way of looking after animals?
That's the jungle out there. I'm sure it'll land softly. And the sea is over that way, too. Say, can things actually swim?
All right. And you'll note that Louie now has a big box fan. Too easy.
The buffet is now completely vegan.
Yay! About time. I almost starved to death.
You should eat small portions.
Well, duh. Because of my intermittent fasting. I'm also doing a trigger warning for my followers from the Plants Are Living Beings community. They always get so cutely indignant when I take a picture of myself in a meadow. Okay, that's one more point on golf.
Okay, so now all I have to do is figure out a way to make the pool water smell better.
I have to go influence somewhere else now.
But two things I must do first. The first one...
so let's see.
...is I do actually need to get the AC fixed back up so that... Louis will not complain when I steal his fan, because of course I'm stealing the fan. And the second one is I need to drop some sleeping pills into the coffee pot.
Okay, this will reverse the effects of the coffee.
And why would I need to reverse the effects of the coffee, you ask? Well...
this air conditioner's driving me crazy. Sometimes too hot, sometimes too cold. Okay, go ahead and take it. I don't need it anymore.
Are you really sure you're not Kip?
I'm, but... I'm Igapian League with...
are you...
you wanna fight me? You wanna? The guy yet? He hit... the guy was total complete... are you one of the...
I'm a...
all that not worth... I'm not... there was this guy... maybe the... at any rate, we gotta stick... me? I have the stuff from the booth. I haven't slept in...
no one would...
whatever the hot freshly...
that's it.
There hasn't been as... no, we are lit, but I still...
inside...
okay, it's... I used to be known, but I can't, even if that... well, but I could...
and just run through all this again, because I'm not sure
so,
what exactly triggers this.
So, I'm off. I'm going now, but I'll be nearby.
None of us are really here.
Somehow I... a tip jar.
That's but... hands off.
But, yeah, we do need to steal Kip's tips. And at some point, you do come back here after you spike the coffee pot, and he will be asleep, and you can steal the quarter that we desperately need.
You could cool a whole room with a giant fan like this.
But before we do that, I think we will go distract Emma.
I want to report some serious pollution.
What? Where?
There's a poor bird caught in an oil spill near the hotel.
What? They'll have to take care of it immediately.
Yes.
Don't touch anything while I'm gone, okay?
Of course not. I don't want to accidentally pollute the environment. Okay, let's see. Hi, can we go?
The raft isn't seaworthy yet. The sail didn't survive. We need a new means of propulsion. The sea is very treacherous here, so we need something like an outboard motor. We still don't know where Faith is. We should find that out first. You still have to pay Bobby that fine. We're not allowed to leave the island until we do.
I'll take care of it.
Something like an outboard motor, eh?
And once again, Larry Laffer has successfully improvised the perfect drive for my raft.
No, I have no idea what's powering it, but...
It doesn't seem too seaworthy yet.
But mission accomplished, and I think I did grab everything I can grab from here. How the heck did she get there?
Headquarters?
Yes?
I've got some new intel on this Larry Laffer.
I'm listening.
He seems to be some kind of mechanical genius. He built something out of the simplest materials. He is able to combine two things that don't really belong together. Then he ends up with something that he can use for a purpose for which it was never even intended. The man is incredible.
Yan Mai, that sounds like he's either too much for you, or you admire him.
Nonsense. I would love to strangle him with my own hands and bury the pieces of his body in a rice field.
Yes, strangle him. Strangle him until he can't breathe. At just the right time. And when he no longer can be.
I understand. Thanks.
All right, well, that still leaves us with the problem of getting the pool water to stop smelling bad, and while that will handle our issues with Governor Bobby Marley, we still need to figure out where Faith is. And we will take care of all of that next time. See you then.